Okay, so this is the product review for the new Smart Beds corn bedding and litter pallets. So we've just got them here. I've taken 400 grams, which is enough to cover a fairly big litter tray. And we're going to pop that in there. And over the next 2 days, we'll be emulating a week's usage by adding 100 millilitres of water to this every couple of hours. So we're just going to pour this on now. And then come back in an hour or so and see how the product has absorbed the water. Okay, so we've come back to this just over an hour later, and as you can see, the 100 mils of water here has hardly affected the bedding. Some of it's crumbled, it's still completely dry. So we're just going to add another 100 mils now, and then we'll come back and see what effect that's had. Okay, so after the second application of water, we're just going to have a look through. The litter or bedding is still extremely dry. We've still got solid pellets here, so there's a lot more yet to absorb. So I'm going to place in the third amount of 100 mils, and this effectively will be the third day of litter, and we'll come back to that and have a look in an hour or so. Okay, so after three applications of water, which effectively is 3 days of urine, we're just going to have a look now, and you can still see here we still have some of these pellets that are solid. The water has been absorbed by the pellets it's come directly into contact with, and there's no excessive moisture. Now I'll just demonstrate that here. Just putting a piece of kitchen towel on the top. And there you can see just a few spots there of moisture. So we're going to apply fourth load of water. Just try and sprinkle that round evenly. And then come back in an hour or so and see what the results are. So after our fourth application of water, we've waited an hour or so. We're just going to have a look now at the litter, and again it's still feeling very dry. There's no excess moisture, and some of the pellets are still still in shape. So this is good news. This is what effectively will be after 4 days. And at this point, because there is a feeling of moisture in here, and most rabbit owners would do this anyway, we'd put hay on the top. This would mean that the rabbit doesn't come into contact with its own urine, and protecting its feet and its bottom from urine scalds. But as I say, this is still fundamentally dry. I'm just going to show you that now with a piece of kitchen roll. And there you can see just a few damp spots. So we're going to throw in the next 100 mils. Actually, it just sort of feels like sawdust, really. It's just got a slight feeling of moisture. Okay. And then we'll come back in an hour or so and see how it is. Okay, so after 5 applications, this is still feeling dry. There's a slight moisture in the middle here, but essentially this is absolutely fine for a rabbit to be bedded on or for using for litter at this point. I'm going to do a quick moisture test. You can see there's just a few spots of moisture there. So we're going to add in another 100 mils. And come back in an hour or so and see what's happened. We've still got no real signs of moisture within the bedding, within the litter. It's starting to clump, but Generally, if it was hanging on top of this, this would be absolutely fine. And again, we'll just show you a moisture test here. And as you can see there, just a few spots. So we're going to add in another 100 mils and come back in a while and see how it's done. So we're just going to have a look after the seventh application. As you can see, we've actually still got dry litter here on the edges. I'm just going to mix that all up a bit. And this is just feeling slightly damp. Squeeze it and there's no residual water coming out of it. It is clumping together just a little bit. But this would be still be dry enough for your rabbit to use as litter or bedding. I'm just going to mix in the edges and then we're going to pour in another 100 mils of water. I'll just do a quick damp test for you. And as you can see, just a few spots. Okay, so next 100 mils goes in. And we'll come back a bit later and see how that's done. So now we've had 8 applications of water and I've actually left this overnight before we put any more on. So we're just going to have a feel here and this is almost completely dry. Very crumbly, as you can tell, we're not clumping together. There's hardly any moisture in here. But we'll just do a quick moisture test for you. You can see there that's almost completely clear. Okay, so we're going to put on another 100 mils. This will be our 9th application. And we'll come back in a bit and see how that's done. We're just going to have a look through. Again, this is just feeling slightly damp. The edges where I've not put the water are dry. And you can see there we've just got just a little bit more moisture. So I'm just going to mix this up. And I would say at this point this is starting to feel, although it's not giving out any water when it's squeezed, it's now starting to feel damp. So I'm going to put on the next 100 mils. And we'll come back in a bit and see how that's done. Okay, so we'll come back to this a couple of hours later and this is really just still feeling damp. If I squeeze this, there's a few drops of water coming out of this now. Again, with some hay on top, this is probably going to be fine, but we're starting to come to the end of the run. So I'm just going to pop in another 100 mils. Oh, sorry, I'll just do a quick test for you here. And you can see there's moisture on there. So we'll pop on another 100 mils here. And come back in a moment. Okay, so after 11 applications of 100 mils of water, we now have a fairly wet litter, which is dropping water when it's squeezed. At this point, I certainly would be changing the litter. However, considering that this is 12 days worth, I think it's fair to say that the product, SmartBeds product, is extremely absorbent.